Not long ago, ChargerLAB made a compatibility 100 video for the Samsung S23 Ultra. You can click the upper right corner to check that. Now, let's take a close look at its overall charging performance. The packaging design of the Ultra this time is highly similar to Apple's. It has a battery capacity of 5000 mAh and supports 45 watts while charging and 50 watts while discharging. The included USB-C cable only supports up to 3 amp. So, if you want to charge your phone at the fastest speed, you need to change to a 5 amp cable. The USB-C port adopts USB 3.2 Gen 1 standard. It supports external monitors, turning your phone into a PC in seconds. You should be familiar with the S Pen. The S Pen does not have a battery and is powered by a built-in capacitor. If you use it for a long time, some functions may be disabled. You need to plug it in and charge it before you can continue to use it. Next, let's get to the test, starting with the compatibility part. As mentioned, the current will be stocked at 26 watts if we use Samsung original chargers and cables. After replacing a 5 amp cable, the power can reach 35 watts. For consistency and fairness, the following tests will be made using a HP Thunderbolt 4 cable. According to our tests, the highest peak power of 9 volts 5 amp PPS can be around 43 watts. The peak power of 3 amp PPS is around 25 watts. Make sure your charger supports the PPS protocol, otherwise the power will only be around 14 watts, even if you use a 5 amp cable. Next, we'll use the Samsung 65 watts charger and a random third-party 6 amp cable to fully charge the S23 Ultra. The voltage fluctuates around 9 volts, and the charging curve can be divided into 6 parts. In the first part, the power stayed around 13 watts for the first minute, then the power increased to 46 watts and continued until 9 minutes. Next, the power gradually drops to 36 watts, 31 watts, and 21 watts in turn. The final part begins at 39 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 1 hour and 14 minutes to be fully charged. We also turn it into another curve. The 65W charger can charge the Samsung S23 Ultra to 50% in 20 minutes, and it can reach 80% in 37 minutes, 100% in 1 hour and 14 minutes. It is actually 41 minutes faster than the iPhone 15 Pro Max and has a larger battery capacity of 578 mAh. We also put the S23 Ultra into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test, and recorded the highest temperatures on the front and back at 3 different time points. After 10 minutes of charging, the highest temperature on the front is 37.3 degrees Celsius, and the back is higher, reaching 39 degrees Celsius. At this time, the peak power jumped from 46 watts to 36 watts. After 20 minutes, the highest temperature on the front slightly increased to 38.6 degrees Celsius, the back is 39.5 degrees Celsius. The temperature has risen slightly compared with the 10-minute charging time. At this time, the phone is still fast charging and the power is about 36 watts. After 30 minutes, the highest temperature on the front slightly dropped to 38.4 degrees Celsius, the back is 38.8 degrees Celsius. At this time, the power has dropped to about 23 watts. Plotting the data into a bar chart, the overall temperature is slightly higher than your body temperature, but it won't exceed 40 degrees Celsius. Because it charges faster, it is slightly hotter than the iPhone 15 Pro Max, but within the normal range. Well, that will be all the tests for this phone. Since it supports the PPS protocol, the charging compatibility is better than most Android phones. But please keep in mind that ordinary PD chargers and 3 amp cables cannot charge your phone at the fastest speed. Its full charging time is noticeably faster than the iPhone 15 Pro Max, and the maximum temperature is acceptable. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!